Alright, welcome to Let's Make a Ref Sheet, the series where I'm going to make a ref sheet from scratch and explain most of the concepts behind it. Now, I'm going to assume for this tutorial that you know the basic key concepts of a spreadsheet, as well as the most essential functions. This is a list of functions I suggest you to learn. It's not required to understand everything in this tutorial, but it's just a good thing to learn regardless. But this is the list of functions that you need to know to understand everything in this tutorial. Feel free to pause or take a screenshot. And if you see something that you don't know about, then I recommend either going to any spreadsheet, going on help and function list, which will give you a list of the list of functions, as well as any more information for about the function. Or there are a lot of good video resources, such as the Learn Google Spreadsheets YouTube channel, which has a lot, and I mean a lot of content for Google Spreadsheets. So if, again, if there's anything, especially from the key concepts, if there's anything you don't know about, check out the YouTube channel or check out the function list. Most of you already know that I already have a template for ref sheets, which is this. It has all instructions to be able to manage them, and this is the basic template. Now, right now it's just a template. It looks pretty empty, but when you fill in the data, it's going to look something like this. This is the ref sheet for past tournament called Deutsche Meisterschaft 4, a German championship, which also served as the OWC qualifiers for the German team. This is what an example match looks like. You can select the maps here, enter the scores here, and everything will be automatically shown. This is the we have a lot of commands in here, an auto-generated room command in here. You can enter your bans. If there's a second ban, you would be able to enter it here. You can enter a ban here. You can enter a no-show, a Wunwell default here, if necessary. There's a current status line that a referee can just take and paste into the MP channel whenever a map has finished. And we have a match results that we can just paste into Discord whenever needed. Now that we've covered that, let's go on to making the actual ref sheet. Alright, let's start with the base sheet, or what I will later on also call the template sheet. First thing I always do when I make a new spreadsheet is I check the local if everything is set correctly. Check the time zone. If you're hosting an international tournament, you probably want to set it to UTC, because using the now and today function in your formula will now properly show in UTC time zone instead of your local time zone. If you're using European local, it might be that formula syntax uses semicolons instead of commas for the separator character, so keep that in mind if you try to copy some of the formulas shown in this video. I'm starting to make a basic layout with example data now. Afterwards, I'm going to change the row and column size to 25, which looks a bit more comfortable and easy on the eyes than the default 21. Then it's a good habit to delete most of the excess rows and columns to save computer resources, browser resources, and to prevent unnecessary scrolling on the viewer's side. The keybind I'm using is Ctrl Shift and Arrow key to select everything until the end if you have something selected already. Then I use a nice dark blue color, the separator rows and columns, to create a nice contrast to the white cells with the content in it. Then I change the font of every cell to Nunito, because honestly, the default Arial looks pretty horrible. Then we also change the vertical alignment to center. This basic procedure of adjusting the row and column size, the dark blue color, and everything around that will be repeated a lot more often for new sheets made in the tutorial, so I'll just skip over it because it's just the same thing over and over again. Now we see the first cell references on the right hand side for the bands, and they change dynamically as the player names change. And now to the first, but more complicated formula, the mpmake. The mpmake command is used in IRC chat to create a multiplayer room. It consists of the tournament abbreviation, which right now is hard-coded, but we will extract it to an external variable later. Then we use an if function to hide the MP make if certain values are missing, and the player names, of course, which we will put in with the concatenation operator, the ampersand, which will also be done very, very often. I recommend looking up the ampersand operator if you don't already know about it. Now let's go to the settings sheet. It's going to be a central place to adjust all tournament settings at once. Again, I create a basic layout without formatting at first. Then I make a few variables, such as the tournament abbreviation, as mentioned. There are also specific settings such as game mode, team mode, score mode, and team size. The settings I use here are the default settings for an also standard 1v1 tournament, which are usually head-to-head, score v1 or v2, and a team size of 1. I then put in all the tournament stage related data, along with example data for best of and bans per stage. Feel free to change this yourself. And then I apply the basic formatting again, as mentioned earlier. On the template sheet, we now make a new dropdown for the stage, which we can do with data validation. This dynamically controls all stage related data, such as best of, number of bans, and later on also the map pool. We also make a dropdown for the first pick, also done with data validation. And we then create the best of label, which we simply do with string concatenation and a simple VLOOKUP formula. Make sure to use an if error, because if a stage can't be found, then it should display nothing. That's it for this episode. Next episode we're going to cover the schedule, the implementation of the schedule into the template sheet, and the auto-generated IRC commands. So until then, see you next time!